Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Shahsar Classes and Evershine Coaching Center. I am Shah Faisal sir here. My dear students, today we are going to discuss class 10 science of Karnataka State Board, very important questions for your upcoming board exam. If you are worried like what we need to study in science, how we can score or even we can pass in science, which are the major topics we need to focus so that the paper will become easy for us. So today if you have any sort of doubts like what all you want to study from each and every chapter, so this is the video for you. Let's begin. So here first let me start from physics passing package. It's not only like a passing or scoring. See, in science everything is passing and everything is scoring, but the objective here is very simple. You need to understand first the given question before you are going to answer it. If we can able to understand the given question, then that is your scoring package. In case if you are not able to understand the given question, then it becomes passing package. That's it, no major differences. First, from the chapter electricity, the first most important question is state Ohm's law. See here we have given some definitions. Can you see this? Illa ven kotidivi solpa questions ge answers kotidivi. In case nim school nalli ಏನಾದರೂ ಆನ್ಸರ್ಸ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ವರ್ಕ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಓಮ್ಸ್ ಲಾ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ನೀವು ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಬಹೈಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ, ಅರ್ಥ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ, ಅದೇ ಬರೀರಿ. ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ರೆಡ್ ಎನಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ನೋ ಯು ನೋ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಚೇಂಜ್ ದ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್. ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್? ಪಹಲೆ ಅಗರ್ಸೆ ಕೋಯಿ ಆನ್ಸರ್ಸ್ ಆಪ್ ಪಡ್ಕೆ ಹೇ ತೊ ಉಸಿಕೋ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಕೀಜಿಯೆ. ಅಬ್ ಹಮಾರೇಕೋ ಯೇ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಸೇ ಬಸ್ ಏಕ್ ಹಿ ಚೀಜ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಹೇ, ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್. ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್? Good. So please keep this point in your mind before you are going to study anything. In case if you have not read any answers, this is the first time you are seeing or you don't know that answer, then you can go ahead with the same answers. Yehi answers ko aap bahet kar sakte hain. Okay. State Ohm's law. What's Ohm's law states that? What's the statement of Ohm's law? At constant temperature, the potential difference across the conductor is directly proportional to the current flowing through it. If you want, you can write the definition. If not, you can also write like this also. The current through a conductor between two points is directly proportional to the voltage across the two points. All are one and the same. Here you can see here V is equals to IR. V is potential difference, I is electric current. And already we know that the general form, the standard formula of Ohm's law, that is V is directly proportional to I, isn't it? V is directly proportional to I. If directly proportional, if you remove, then it becomes what you have to write, R. V is equals to I into R. What is R? That is the proportionality constant. That is nothing but proportionality constant. The another name of R is resistance. Good. Next question, state Joule's law of heating. What Joule's law states? The amount of heat produced in a current conducting wire is proportional to the square of the amount of current that is flowing through the wire when the electrical resistance of the wire and the time of current flowing through them are constant. In short, we can also write that as H is equals to I square RT. So if you want, even you can write this as your statement of Joule's law. If not, even you can also write this as the statement of Joule's law. Both are one in the same. See, in the formula itself, we have the statement of Joule's law. Can you see that? Can you see this? H is equals to I square RT. That is square of the current. I square. Square of the current. R is resistance. T is time. Can you see here? Heat is produced in a resistor is directly proportional to square of the current. Directly proportional to resistance, directly proportional to time. So all are directly proportional. Any doubts? Sometimes you may get the question like this also. For the same definition, they will ask you the question even this. What is that means? Write the factors on which the heat produced in a resistor depends. Write the factors on which heat produced in a conductor. Sorry, heat produced in a conductor depends. Heat produced in a conductor depends on current, resistance and time. There also you are supposed to write the same answer. So in this chapter we have two important questions. Which are those? Mention the factors on which resistance of a conductor depends, isn't it? Mention the factors on which resistance of a conductor depends. One more question. Mention the factors on which heat produced in a conductor depends. So heat produced in a conductor depends on current, resistance and time. Any doubt? Good. Next question is electric power. So what is electric power? Electric power, it is a measure of the rate of electrical energy transferred by an electric circuit per unit time. Electric power is defined as, it is a measure of the rate of electrical energy. Kitna aap electrical energy ko transfer kar rahe hain? Kitna aap energy ko transfer kar rahe hain? How much amount of energy you are transferring by a circuit per unit time? Ek second mein kitna energy aapka transfer hua hai? Ek jagah se dusri jagah ko. Usko hum bolte hain electric power. Did you understood? How much amount of energy you have transferred in 1 second? In 1 second per unit time is nothing but in 1 second, how much amount of energy you have transferred from one point to another point. So that measure is known as electric power. Any doubts? So the standard unit of electric power is watt. Don't forget, the standard unit of electric power is watt. Understood? Still more, if the value is bigger, kilowatt. What is the commercial unit of electric power? Kilowatt hour, KWH. One of the most important question for 1 mark in multiple choice question. As you can see here, we have 3 formulas. So based on these 3 formulas, you can expect a numerical, one small problem, which carries either 1 mark or 2 mark. So you need to remember all these 3 formulas. So please make sure that, so it's a definite and guaranteed question you can expect. So power, P is equals to V into I. If, and one more formula, P is equals to I square R. One more formula, P is equals to V square by R. P is equals to V square by R. Now, resistors are connected in series and parallel. As you know that, see, all the 3 diagrams are one and the same. But here, usually we follow the second diagram. Can you see this? Isn't it? In your textbook, already it's mentioned this diagram. Isn't it? When the resistors are connected in series, you can see R1, R2 and R3. These are the 3 resistors. As you can see, they are connected adjacent to each other. Baju, 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 hum connect karke hain. Agar se hum baju, uske baju mein agar se connect karke ja rahe hain, to hum usko bolte hain series. Similarly, you can see in the below diagram. Can you see here? Here resistors are connected one below the other. Ek ke niche ek ko connect karke hain. To hum usko bolte hain parallel. Any doubts? In this figure, as you can see here, ammeter is connected in series, voltmeter is connected in parallel. Even in when the resistors are connected in parallel, here also you can see ammeter is connected in series, voltmeter is connected in parallel. So either let it be series combination or parallel combination, always ammeter is connected in series, voltmeter is connected in parallel. Fuse is connected in series. Fuse. That is also one of the most important question. They may ask you, how the fuse is connected in an electric circuit? How the fuse is connected in an electric circuit? It is connected in series. Don't forget that point. Now we have the standard formula. RS means resistors are connected in series. So RS is equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3. When the resistors are connected in parallel, then we have the formula 1 by RP. RP means resistors are connected in parallel. So this is also called as this RS. This is total resistance and it is also called as effective resistance. Effective resistance or total resistance, both are same. Understood? When the resistors are connected in series, RS is equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3. So what is the effective resistance? R1 plus R2 plus R3. That is also called as effective resistance. Here we have 3 resistors. So 3 times R1, R2, R3. If there are 2 resistors, only R1 plus R2. If there are 4 resistors, R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus R4. Followed? Understood? When the resistors are connected in parallel, then 1 by RP is equals to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Any doubts? Good. Next question. One of the most important question. What is electric current? And write the SI unit of it. So this could be a question. So what is electric current? A stream of electrons moving through a conductor constitutes an electric current. If not, the rate of flow of charges per unit time is called as electric current. Even you can write the answer this also. The rate of flow of charges per unit time is called as electric current. The SI unit of electric current is ampere. And one more important question you can expect. What is potential difference? Write the SI unit of it. So what is potential difference? The amount of work which is done to move a unit positive charge from one point to another point is called as potential difference. अगर से हमारे पास एक चार्ज है, we have one charge, वो एक चार्ज को हमारे को क्या करना है, एक जगह से दूसरी जगह को पहुंचाना है, we want to shift, तो हम उसके ऊपर कुछ वर्क कर रहे हैं, we are applying some force, yes or no? अगर से आपके पास एक बुक है, एक बुक को आप एक जगह से दूसरी जगह को पहुंचाना है, तो क्या करते हैं आप, उसके ऊपर कुछ वर्क करते हैं, means you are lifting from your hand, what is that? That is work, understood? You are blowing air, आप हवा फूंक रहे हैं, तो इसकी वजह से क्या हो रहा है, वो फोर्स की वजह से वो एक पोजीशन से दूसरी पोजीशन को वो जा रहा है, पहुंच रहा है, isn't it? Are you getting my point? So that is what is called as potential difference. So what is potential difference? The amount of work done to move a unit positive charge from one point to another point is called as potential difference. Any doubts? आप कितना काम कर रहे हैं, how much amount of work you are going to do, how much amount of work is being used to move a unit positive charge from one point to another point is called as potential difference. The SI unit of potential difference is volt. The SI unit of potential difference is volt. So how do you measure current? Which is the device you are going to use? To measure the current, ammeter. Ammeter is the device which is used to measure the electric current. Similarly, which is the device is used to measure the potential difference? Voltmeter. Voltmeter. Any doubts? Now here we have the formula to find the electric current, that is I is equals to Q by T. Q is called as charge, T is called as time. SI unit of charge is coulomb. SI unit of time is seconds, that is the standard. Even minutes, hours also are there, but standard we use seconds. Any doubts? And here you can see a chart, electric current formula, I is equals to Q by T. If you want to find Q, I into T, time, T means Q by I, same I is equals to Q by T formula, take T left hand side, so I will come down, so it becomes Q by I. Potential difference, V is equals to W by Q. Work done, W is equals to V into Q, and also you can see in the other side there are the SI units. Potential difference, SI unit is volt, work done is joule, resistance is ohm, resistivity rho. I hope you remember the formula. R is equals to rho L by A, yes. So ohm meter, electric power, watt, electric energy, watt hour, commercial unit of electric energy is kilowatt hour. Similarly, the next important question is, what is resistivity? What is resistivity? It is an electrical resistance of a conductor of unit cross-section area and unit length. That is known as resistivity. So R is equals to rho L by A. So here you need to remember one most important point. So R is resistance, L is length, A is area of cross-section, and rho is resistivity. You don't worry about rho. So rho is constant. For different material, we have different rho values. So copper की resistivity अलग है, iron की resistivity अलग है, समझ में आया बेटा? So हर metal का, हर compound का resistivity अलग अलग रहेगा. क्यों बोले तो उनके properties change होंगे और उनकी strength भी change होगी. उनके strength के हिसाब से उनकी resistivity दी जाएगी. Understood? And here you no need to buy any values of rho. Already it is given in the table. Or else in the question itself they'll give you the value of rho. You no need to by head the values of resistivity, rho values, they will mention in the question itself. Okay, so here important question is R. If R increases, L also increases, A decreases, because R is directly proportional to L, Here R is directly inversely proportional to A, area of cross section, isn't it? Followed? Understood? Good. Next question, write the factors on which resistance of a conductor depends. Just now I told you in the beginning. So which are the factors on which resistance of a conductor depends? Length, area of cross section, nature of its material. In case if we have forgotten, see here, I'll give you the logic. अगर से आपको factors याद नहीं है तो आपको क्या करना है, ये फार्मूला को याद रखना है. कैन यू सी दिस, दिस फार्मूला यू हैव टू रिमेंबर. कैन यू सी दिस, रेजिस्टेंस मींस आर. सो विच आर द फैक्टर्स ऑन रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ ए कंडक्टर डिपेंड्स. एल इज लेंथ. कैन यू सी हियर, वी हैव लेंथ. ए इज एरिया, वी हैव एरिया. रो, रो इज नथिंग बट नेचर ऑफ द मटीरियल, दैट इज रेजिस्टिविटी. अंडरस्टूड? फॉर हीट प्रोड्यूस्ड इन ए कंडक्टर डिपेंड्स एच इक्वल साइज स्क्वायर आर टी. रिमेंबर दैट फार्मूला. So it depends on heat produced, it depends on electric current, understood? I, it depends on resistance, it depends on time. So those are the factors. Any doubts? Understood, children? Good. Next question, write the differences between ammeter and voltmeter. So ammeter, it is used to measure the current. Voltmeter, it is used to measure the potential difference. Ammeter, it is connected in series. Voltmeter, it is connected in parallel. Ammeter has low resistance, voltmeter has high resistance. Any doubts?
No, sir.
Any doubts? Ammeter has low resistance. Ammeter has low resistance. Voltmeter has high resistance. What do you mean by resistance? Stopping the current. The property of the the property of the material. So what is resistance? It is a property. It is a property. What property? To stop the flow of electrons, to stop the flow of charges, that is resistance. Understood? So it resists the flow of charges. Agar se aapko pure physical word mein likhna ho to, it is a property which resists the flow of charges. Resist means stop. Resist, R-E-S-I-S-T. Resist means stop. Samajh mein beta? Jitna aapka resistance zyada hoga, utna aapka current फ्लो होना कम होगा. समझ में बेटा? अंडरस्टूड और नॉट? हाउ वी विल गेट टू नो? वी नो ओम्स लॉ, वी इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू आई. सो वी इज इक्वल्स टू आई आर, देन आर इज इक्वल्स टू वी बाई आई, इजंट इट? इफ आर इंक्रीजेस, आई डिक्रीजेस. इफ आर डिक्रीजेस, आई इंक्रीजेस. जहां पे करंट ज्यादा होगा उधर रेजिस्टेंस कम होगा, जिधर पे रेजिस्टेंस ज्यादा होगा उधर पे करंट कम होगा. अंडरस्टूड? इट्स वाइस वर्सा. एनी डाउट्स? गुड. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, राइट द डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन रेजिस्टिविटी एंड रेजिस्टेंस. कैन यू सी दिस? रेजिस्टिविटी, इट इज द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द मटेरियल. एक प्रॉपर्टी बेटा, एक नेचर. रेजिस्टिविटी इज द नेचर. बट रेजिस्टेंस इज द, इट इज द अपोजिशन टू फ्लो द टू द फ्लो ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इन ए सब्सटेंस. So opposition, opposition means stopping, resist the current, resist the flow of charges, that is resistance. Resistivity is intrinsic property. Resistivity kya hai? Intrinsic property. Resistance is extrinsic property. Samajh mein beta? Ye aakar intrinsic property hai aur inhe aakar extrinsic property hai. Now the resistivity of a conductor is always same and it is independent of its length or size. Iska bolne ka matlab, चाहे एक सब्सटेंस लो, यू टेक वन सब्सटेंस, उसका लेंथ चाहे इंक्रीज करो या डिक्रीज करो, या उसका एरिया इंक्रीज करो या डिक्रीज करो, उसकी प्रॉपर्टी वही रहेगी. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आई विल टेक वन आयरन पीस. व्हाट आई हैव टेकन? आयरन ऑफ लेंथ 2 meters. 2 meter का एक आयरन रॉड लिया हूँ, उसको मैं मेल्ट कर दिया, आई एम मेल्टेड, और उसे मैं फिर मैन्युफैक्चर किया. उसको मैं क्या कर दिया, पहले वो 2 meters था, अभी मैं उसको क्या किया, 5 meters में कन्वर्ट कर दिया. नाउ आई हैव रीचेंज, शेप हैज मॉडिफाइड, शेप उसका चेंज हुआ. पहले उसका शेप 2 centimeter में कुछ तरह का था, आई मीन 2 meters में उसका शेप एक जैसा था. अब मैं उसको क्या कर दिया, एक राउंड बॉल बना दिया. आफ्टर मेल्टिंग दैट, व्हाट आई डिड, आई मेड ए बॉल. नो, शेप हैज चेंज्ड, लेंथ हैज चेंज्ड, एरिया हैज चेंज्ड. कुछ भी चेंज होने दो, उसकी प्रॉपर्टी वही रहेगी. दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस. एनी डाउट्स? द रेजिस्टिविटी रिमेन्स सेम, चाहे आप वो मेट क्यों क्यों रेजिस्टिविटी सेम है, वो पहले भी आयरन ही था अभी भी आयरन पीस ही है, पहले भी वो गोल्ड था अभी भी गोल्ड है, खाली उसका शेप को मॉडिफाई किया है लेकिन उसके अंदर का कंपोजिशन सेम है, उसके अंदर के प्रॉपर्टीज सेम ही रहेंगे। समझ में आया? पहले वो बैट था अब उसको हम बॉल में कन्वर्ट कर दिए तो उसके प्रॉपर्टीज चेंज नहीं होगी, उसकी स्टिफनेस चेंज नहीं होगी, उसका लस्चर चेंज नहीं होगा, सब चीज वही रहेगा। दैट इज कॉल्ड एज इंट्रेंसिक प्रॉपर्टी, दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इंट्रेंसिक प्रॉपर्टी। डिड यू अंडरस्टूड? इट मीन्स द प्रॉपर्टी रिमेन्स सेम, आइदर यू चेंज इट्स लेंथ और एरिया और साइज और वॉट एवर इट इज। नेक्स्ट, इन दिस केस द रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ अ कंडक्टर इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन इट्स लेंथ और साइज, वो लेंथ और साइज के ऊपर डिपेंड होगा। रेजिस्टेंस क्या होगा? उसका लेंथ और साइज के ऊपर डिपेंड होगा। जैसा उसका लेंथ चेंज होगा तो रेजिस्टेंस भी चेंज होगा, जैसा उसका साइज चेंज होगा रेजिस्टेंस भी चेंज होगा। आई विल गिव वन स्मॉल एग्जांपल, टेक वन वॉल्व, पानी का वॉल्व ऑन ऑफ करने का, उसके अंदर एक नोजल होता है, कैन यू सी दिस, या समझो एक बॉल जैसा होता है, जब हम ऑफ करेंगे तो बॉल क्या हो जाएगा, पाइप के पास आ जाएगा तो पानी को बाहर आने नहीं देगा। आई मीन योर टैप ऑन एंड ऑफ, ऑन किया तो उसका मतलब क्या है, बॉल साइड में जाएगा जिसकी वजह से पानी फ्लो होगा। लेट मी से एग्जांपल, ओके हाँ एग्जांपल, लेट मी टेक ए टैप, एक छोटा सा एक नल लेंगे बेटा, एक छोटा सा एक नल लेंगे और एक बड़ा सा एक टैप लेंगे। आई विल टेक टू डिफरेंट टैप्स, वन स्मॉलर टैप, अदर वन इज बिगर टैप। अब स्मॉलर टैप में एक बॉल होगा, कितना एग्जांपल, एक 2 सेंटीमीटर का बॉल है जो पानी के फ्लो को कंट्रोल कर रहा है। आर यू गेटिंग? एक बड़ा टैप है, हो सकता है उसमें 10 सेंटीमीटर का एक बॉल है। हाउ मच सेंटीमीटर? 10 सेंटीमीटर बॉल है। अगर से आप बड़े टैप के अंदर 2 सेंटीमीटर बॉल अगर से फिट कर दिए तो पानी स्टॉप होगा। आर यू गेटिंग? यू कैन सी व्हेन साइज चेंजेस रेजिस्टेंस आल्सो चेंजेस। आर यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? अगर से एक छोटा टैप लो उसमें 10 सेंटीमीटर का बॉल फिट कर दो, चाहे आप ऑन करो या ऑफ करो पानी जाएगा ही नहीं, बिकॉज कंप्लीटली इट विल ब्लॉक। You understood my point? Anyhow. Now, the unit of resistivity is ohm meter. The unit of resistance is ohm. So, did you find the difference between resistivity and resistance? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Good. Now, important definitions. What is 1 ampere? Beta, isme se question aane ke chances zyada hain. But they won't ask you direct question like this. What is 1 ampere? They will ask you, define the unit of electric current. तो आपको पता होना है उसका यूनिट क्या है, एम्पेयर। तो वो हमारे को क्या पूछ रहे हैं, एम्पेयर को डिफाइन करने के लिए। डिड यू अंडरस्टूड? डिफाइन द यूनिट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट मींस एम्पेयर। व्हाट इज 1 एम्पेयर? 1 एम्पेयर इज कॉन्स्टिट्यूटेड बाय द फ्लो ऑफ 1 कूलम ऑफ चार्ज पर सेकेंड, पर यूनिट टाइम, पर सेकेंड। व्हाट इज 1 कूलम? व्हाट दे मे आस्क यू, कन्वर्ट 1 कूलम इनटू इलेक्ट्रॉन्स। दे वोंट आस्क डेफिनेशन, व्हाट इज 1 कूलम दे मे नॉट आस्क, बट दे विल आस्क यू द कन्वर्शन। 1 कूलम को आप इलेक्ट्रॉन्स में कन्वर्ट करो, हाउ मच 1 कूलम इज इक्वल्स टू हाउ मेनी इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, 6 × 10⁻¹⁸ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स। व्हाट इज 1 वोल्ट? डेफिनेशन इज देयर। व्हाट इज 1 ओम? डेफिनेशन इज देयर। व्हाट इज 1 वैट? डेफिनेशन इज देयर। व्हाट इज 1 किलोवाट? 1000 वैट्स इज इक्वल्स टू 1 किलोवाट, एंड दिस इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट कन्वर्शन। व्हाट इज 1 kWh? सो 1 kWh इफ यू कन्वर्ट इनटू जूल्स, इट बिकम्स 3.6 × 10⁻⁶ जूल्स। Any doubts? Next question, write the practical applications of heating effect of electric current. Where all we are using heating effect of electric current? We are using in electric bulb and also we are using in fuse. Beta, iske andar jo point hai, 100% important hai. Again, I'm repeating, 100% important. This point. What it means? See here, electric bulb. A strong metal with high melting point such as tungsten. This is important. Because already this point has appeared in the exam. अंडरस्टूड? कौन सा सब्सटेंस यूज कर रहे हैं इलेक्ट्रिक बल्ब में? टंगस्टन। वी आर यूजिंग टंगस्टन। वाई वी यूज टंगस्टन बिकॉज इट हैज हाई मेल्टिंग पॉइंट. सो विच इज द मेटल इज यूज इन द इलेक्ट्रिक बल्ब? टंगस्टन. टंगस्टन इज द मेटल विच वी यूज इन इलेक्ट्रिक बल्ब बिकॉज इट हैज हाई मेल्टिंग पॉइंट. जस्ट थोड़ा सा भी टेम्परेचर दिया तो मेल्ट नहीं होगा. जब ज्यादा से ज्यादा टेम्परेचर अटेंड होगा उसके बाद में वो मेल्ट होगा. थोड़े एक दिन दो दिन बल्ब जलाने से बल्ब मेल्ट नहीं होगा. ज्यादा से ज्यादा जब टेम्परेचर अटेंड होगा उसी टाइम पे वो टंगस्टन मेल्ट हो सकता है. उससे पहले टंगस्टन मेल्ट नहीं होगा. सो दैट इज द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ दिस. एनी डाउट्स? इट्स ए स्ट्रॉन्ग मेटल विच हैज हाई मेल्टिंग पॉइंट सच एज टंगस्टन इज यूज बिकॉज द बल्ब फिलामेंट शुड बी थर्मली आइसोलेटेड एज मच एज पॉसिबल. उसको थर्मली आइसोलेट करना है. आइसोलेट का मतलब क्या है? व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय थर्मल? थर्मल मीन्स हीट. फिजिक्स में थर्मल को क्या बोलते हैं? हीट. आइसोलेटेड मतलब कि ज्यादा से ज्यादा हीट डिसिपिएट होना है, हीट अब्सॉर्ब होना है, हीट लिबरेट नहीं होना है. एनी डाउट? समझ में आ बेटा? अंडरस्टूड और नॉट? इट शुड बी थर्मली आइसोलेटेड एज मच एज पॉसिबल. नेक्स्ट, फ्यूज. इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ ए पीस ऑफ वायर मेड ऑफ मेटल और एन अलॉय. हियर वन अगेन वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन हैज अराइव्ड. व्हाट इज एन अलॉय? What is alloy? It's a homogeneous mixture of two or more metals and non-metals. It's called as alloy. Don't forget the definition. And they will ask you one table. Bronze mein kaun sa alloy use kiya hai? Bronze. Understood. And brass. Brass mein kaun sa? Solder metal. Solder gun. Usme kaun sa mein alloy ko istemal kiya hai? They may ask you the composition. Please make a note of this point somewhere and later you can revise it. अगेन आई एम रिपीटिंग, दे विल आस्क यू द क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन अलॉय. ब्रॉन्ज देंगे, ब्रास देंगे, सोल्डर गन देंगे, ऐसे अलग अलग अलॉयज देंगे. वो अलॉय बनाने के लिए कौन से मेटल्स का इस्तेमाल किया है. सो यू नीड टू राइट विच आर द मेटल्स आर नॉन मेटल्स इज बीन यूज टू मेक दैट अलॉय. एनी डाउट्स? ओके. फ्यूज इज प्लेस्ड इन सीरीज. जस्ट नो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, राइट? एमीटर इज कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज, वोल्ट मीटर इज कनेक्टेड इन पैरेलल, फ्यूज इज कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज. They will ask you, write the function of fuse, isn't it? Write the function of fuse. Fuse ka function kya hai? It protects circuits and appliances by stopping the flow of any unduly high electric current. Agar se overloading ho gaya, short circuit ke chances mein, kya karta hai fuse? Hamara jo circuit hai usko protect karega. It protects from high electric current. ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा जब ओवरलोडिंग होगा तो ज़्यादा करंट फ्लो होना शुरू हो जाएगा, जिसके वजह से हमारे जो भी सब्सटेंसेस हम भी यूज़ करें घर पे, तो वो सब्सटेंसेस का एक प्रोटेक्शन है. वो इट इज़ प्रोटेक्टिंग द अप्लायंसेस, इलेक्ट्रिकल अप्लायंसेस इन ए सर्क्यूट. एनी डाउट्स? फॉर द डोमेस्टिक पर्पस फ्यूज रेट्स आर. हमारे डोमेस्टिक पर्पस को कौन से फ्यूज ले रहे हैं, कौन से रेटिंग के फ्यूजेस ले रहे हैं? We are using the fuses. What is the rating? 1A, 2A, 3A, 5A, 10A, etc. So these are the rating. Har ek cheez ka alag alag rating hota hai. I hope you may have seen, if you have taken any LED TVs or refrigerator, 3 rating, 4 star, 3 star, 5 star. Have you seen that rating? Yes, that is how even fuse also is been rated. Samajh mein beta? Matlab ki tumhara electrical gadget kitna पावर उसमें अब्सॉर्ब हो रहा है उसके हिसाब से हम फ्यूज को लगाएंगे. डिड यू अंडरस्टूड? अगर से कम पावर है तो 1A का फ्यूज लगाएंगे. अगर से बहुत ज्यादा, समझो आप एग्जांपल, व्हाट वी से योर मोटर, पानी की मोटर है घर पे, उसको कितना फ्यूज लगाएंगे? उसमें तो ज्यादा पावर खींच रहा है. सो इवन वी कैन अप्लाई 10A, इवन वी कैन अप्लाई 25A. समझ में आ बेटा? जितना पावर ज्यादा यूज करेंगे उतना स्ट्रांग फ्यूज को लगाया जाएगा. अंडरस्टूड? यू हैव योर रिस्ट वॉचेस, वॉचेस हैं जो हम हाथ में पहन रहे हैं, वो भी पावर है ना, उसमें भी. सो उसके अंदर भी फ्यूज लगाया है. सो देयर वी कैन अप्लाई 1A फ्यूज. ऐसा. सो पावर के रिलेटेड फ्यूज को इस्तेमाल करेंगे. बट हियर यू नो नीड टू स्टडी सो डीप, जस्ट यू नीड टू रिमेंबर द रेटिंग ऑफ फ्यूज, दैट्स इट. Any doubts? No, important questions with answers. They may ask you these questions. Please observe here. Why is the series arrangement not used for domestic circuit? Why we are not using series arrangement? Why we are using? Iska aur ek opposite hai question. What is the opposite question of this? Why the parallel arrangement इज यूज इन डोमेस्टिक सर्क्यूट, ये इसका ऑपोजिट क्वेश्चन है। हमारे डोमेस्टिक पर्पसेस के अंदर हम सीरीज अरेंजमेंट नहीं इस्तेमाल कर रहे हैं, वी आर नॉट यूजिंग द सीरीज अरेंजमेंट। हाउ वी आर कनेक्टिंग द डिवाइसेस और अप्लायंसेस, वी आर कनेक्टिंग देम इन पैरेलल। व्हाई, व्हाट इज द रीजन? आई होप यू नो द आंसर्स फॉर दिस। या व्हाट आर द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ कनेक्टिंग इलेक्ट्रिकल डिवाइसेस इन पैरेलल? वन मोर क्वेश्चन, आपको पैरेलल में कनेक्ट करने से आपको क्या फायदा होगा? सो व्हाई डू वी कनेक्ट द इलेक्ट्रिकल अप्लायंसेस इन पैरेलल? नेक्स्ट, व्हाई आर कॉयल्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक टोस्टर एंड इलेक्ट्रिक आयरन्स मेड अप ऑफ एन अलॉय रादर देन ए प्योर मेटल? आर यू गेटिंग चिल्ड्रन? टोस्टर और इलेक्ट्रिक आयरन्स जो है हम उसको अलॉय से इस्तेमाल कर रहे हैं, मतलब कि उसको बनाने के लिए अलॉय का इस्तेमाल कर रहे हैं। टू मैन्युफैक्चर दोज आयरन बॉक्स आर टोस्टर्स ओवन्स, अंडरस्टूड? फॉर दिस ऑल गैजेट्स वी आर यूजिंग अलॉय, वी आर नॉट यूजिंग प्योर मेटल। व्हाई, व्हाट इज द रीजन? अंडरस्टूड? एंड वन स्मॉल बेसिक क्वेश्चन, ए करंट ऑफ 0.5 एम्पेयर इज ड्रॉन बाय फिलामेंट ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रिक बल्ब फॉर 10 मिनट्स। अब देखो बेटा, ऐसे क्वेश्चंस में क्या करना है आपको, बस डेटा लिखना है। नाउ व्हाट इज द डेटा? आई इज इक्वल्स टू 0.5 एम्पेयर एंड 10 मिनट्स टाइम, टाइम इज गिवन इन मिनट्स, सो कन्वर्ट इन टू सेकेंड्स। सो मिनट्स टू सेकेंड्स मल्टीप्लाई बाई 60, सो 10 इंटू 60, सो 600 सेकेंड्स। सो टाइम इज 600 सेकेंड्स। सो दे हियर व्हाट दे हैव गिवन, आई दे हैव गिवन एंड टी दे हैव गिवन। सो फर्स्ट राइट आई वैल्यू, देन राइट टी वैल्यू। आफ्टर राइटिंग आई एंड टी, नाउ व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन? फाइंड द अमाउंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज, दैट इज क्यू। दे आर आस्किंग अस टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू। अब हमारे पास क्यू किस में है, कौन से फार्मूला में क्यू आएगा? वी नो दैट आई इज इक्वल्स टू क्यू बाई टी, इलेक्ट्रिक करेंट फार्मूला। आई इज इक्वल्स टू क्यू बाई टी। नो वॉट वी वॉन्ट? क्यू। सो वॉट इज क्यू फार्मूला? नो क्यू इज इक्वल्स टू आई इन टू टी। नो दे हैव गिवन आई वैल्यू 0.5, दे हैव गिवन टी वैल्यू, दे हैव गिवन टी वैल्यू, वॉट द वैल्यू ऑफ टी? 600। सो 0.5 इंटू 600 इट गिव्स यू 300 कूलम सी। सो दैट इज द वैल्यू। एनी डाउट्स? डिड यू अंडरस्टूड हाउ टू फाइंड, हाउ टू सॉल्व दिस न्यूमेरिकल? बस आपको मेन डेटा लिखना है और फार्मूला सब्स्टिट्यूट करना है, बस उतना ही, और दूसरा कुछ करने की जरूरत नहीं है। एनी डाउट्स? वन मोर क्वेश्चन, कैन यू सी दिस? दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, विच ऑल द न्यूमेरिकल्स आर शोन हियर, सो प्लीज एंश्योर इट। हाउ मच वर्क इज डन, व्हाट दे आर आस्किंग? डब्ल्यू, वर्क डन, डब्ल्यू इज इक्वल्स टू क्वेश्चन मार्क, गॉट इट? इन मूविंग ए चार्ज ऑफ 2 कूलम, सो क्यू वैल्यू इज 2c, क्यू इज इक्वल्स टू 2c across two points having a potential difference 12 volt. Now they have given V value. We know that W is equals to V into Q. We have already the formula, list of formulas, just now we have seen above. So W equals V into Q. V value they have given directly 12. Q value they have given directly 2. So 12 into 2, 24 joules. So work done is 24 joules. Any doubts? Similarly, even here also you can see the numericals are there. Later you can revise it. Next chapter is magnetic effect of electric current. So there are important rules you need to remember. It is one of the most important question. Can you see this? Fleming's right hand thumb rule. What Fleming's right hand thumb rule says that if a current carrying conductor is imagined to be held in right hand such that thumb points in the direction of current. Assume you are holding a piece of some iron rod or something. Can you see this one substance a person is holding? Where his thumb indicates upward, thumb indicates upward direction, isn't it? So thumb indicates the direction of current. Can you see this? So this is the direction of current. The curled fingers, can you see this? The fingers which is crossed, can you see this here? The fingers which is crossed, what that indicates? The curled fingers of hand indicates the direction of magnetic field, direction of magnetic field. Any doubts? Understood? If your hand is in the downward direction, can you see this? If the hand is in the downward direction, can you see this? Now how is the direction of magnetic field? Can you see this? Can you see this? Yes, sir. Beta, fingers ko se side mein hai? Fingers is facing towards which direction?
Right side.
Right side. So direction of magnetic field is also in the right side. अगर से फिंगर्स आपके लेफ्ट साइड इंडिकेट कर रहे हैं सो डायरेक्शन ऑफ द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज ऑल्सो लेफ्ट साइड। दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट बेटा, समझ में आए? अगर से आपके हैंड है, थंब है, आपके फिंगर्स, ये फोर फिंगर्स जो हैं किस डायरेक्शन में आपको दिख रहे हैं, उस डायरेक्शन में मैग्नेटिक फील्ड है, दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंट। अगर से ये राइट साइड में हो रहे हैं तो राइट साइड, अगर से लेफ्ट साइड में हो रहे हैं तो लेफ्ट साइड, मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज इन द लेफ्ट साइड डायरेक्शन। एनी डाउट्स? अंडरस्टूड? कॉन्सेप्ट आर क्लियर? गुड, अंडरस्टूड और नॉट? हाँ, तो ये डायग्राम से हमारे को एक चीज मालूम हुई, वॉट डिड वी अंडरस्टूड? इफ यू आर होल्डिंग थंब रूल, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज राइट हैंड थंब रूल। सी, वी हैव टू रूल्स, वी हैव टू रूल्स। फ्लेमिंग्स राइट हैंड रूल इज डिफरेंट, राइट हैंड थंब रूल इज डिफरेंट। एनी डाउट्स? सॉरी, दिस इज नॉट कॉल्ड एज फ्लेमिंग, सॉरी, इट इज कॉल्ड एज मैक्सवेल्स थंब रूल, मैक्सवेल्स राइट हैंड थंब रूल, मैक्सवेल्स राइट हैंड थंब रूल। दिस इज मैक्सवेल्स राइट हैंड थंब रूल स्टेट्स दैट, फ्लेमिंग्स राइट हैंड रूल स्टेट्स दैट, अरेंज द थ्री फिंगर्स म्यूचुअली परपेंडिकुलर टू ईच अदर, थंब फिंगर इंडिकेट्स डायरेक्शन ऑफ द मोशन ऑफ द कंडक्टर, फोर फिंगर इंडिकेट्स डायरेक्शन ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, एंड मिडिल फिंगर इंडिकेट्स डायरेक्शन ऑफ इंड्यूस्ड करेंट। देर आर थ्री फिंगर्स आर देर इन फ्लेमिंग्स राइट हैंड रूल, वी आर यूजिंग थ्री फिंगर्स, इन मैक्सवेल्स थंब रूल वी आर यूजिंग ओनली टू फिंगर्स, ओनली वी आर यूजिंग थंब एंड वी आर यूजिंग दिस फोर लाइन्स। कैन यू सी दिस फोर फिंगर्स? कैन सी दिस 1, 2, 3, 4? ओनली दिस टू थिंग्स वी आर कंसिडरिंग इन थंब रूल। एनी डाउट्स? डिड यू अंडरस्टूड और नॉट? समटाइम दे मे गिव यू द डायग्राम लाइक दिस, अपॉन दिस डायग्राम दे मे आस्क यू आइडेंटिफाई द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड। एक में क्या करेंगे, दिख रहा है बेटा इधर, एरो मार्क ऐसा है, एरो मार्क ऐसा जा रहा है, राइट राइट हैंड साइड दे विल शो द एरो मार्क, लेफ्ट हैंड साइड दे विल शो द एरो मार्क। आर यू गेटिंग? अंडरस्टूड? एंड बोथ गोइंग दिस साइड लेफ्ट साइड ओनली, बोथ गोइंग राइट साइड ओनली, लाइक दिस ऑल्सो दे कैन गिव यू द डायग्राम। सो यू हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल बिफोर यू आर गोइंग टू आइडेंटिफाई विच इज द राइट आंसर। अंडरस्टूड? जो डायरेक्शन में आपके चार उंगलियां दिख रहे हैं वही डायरेक्शन में मैग्नेटिक फील्ड है। तो थंब के डायरेक्शन में क्या है? डायरेक्शन ऑफ करेंट। डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज। इन राइट हैंड रूल थंब फिंगर इंडिकेट्स डायरेक्शन ऑफ द मोशन ऑफ द कंडक्टर, इन मैक्सवेल थंब रूल थंब फिंगर इंडिकेट्स डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करेंट। एनी डाउट? अंडरस्टूड और नॉट? श्योर? गुड। Now Fleming's left hand rule, already we have seen, left hand rule is also called as motor rule and right hand rule is also called as generator rule or dynamo rule, both are one and the same. Any doubts? Concepts are clear? One of the most very 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 important question, please don't neglect this question, it is one of the most important question. और इसके अंदर सारे points जो है नी, इसमें से ये दो या तीन पॉइंट्स के ऊपर गिव रीजंस क्वेश्चंस भी दिए जा सकते हैं, दे विल आस्क यू गिव रीजंस क्वेश्चंस। एनी हाउ लेट मी सी, सो राइट द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस, दे आर ऑलवेज फॉर्म क्लोज लूप्स, राइट? कैन सी दिस, दे आर इन अ कर्व्ड शेप, मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस आर इन ए कर्व्ड लाइंस, दे आर कॉल्ड एज क्लोज शेप्स। नो टू मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस इंटरसेक्ट्स, इट मीन्स नो लाइंस विल इंटरसेक्ट। दिख रहा है बेटा, ये एक मैग्नेटिक फील्ड है, इसके नीचे एक लाइन जा रही है, इसके नीचे, इसके नीचे, कभी भी ये दो लाइंस एक दूसरे से टकराएंगे नहीं, नेवर दिस टू लाइंस विल इंटरसेक्ट विथ ईच अदर, मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस नेवर इंटरसेक्ट ईच अदर, ऐसा भी लिख सकते हैं। एनी डाउट्स? अंडरस्टूड? एंड इट इज ए वेक्टर क्वांटिटी, दे लीव फ्रॉम नॉर्थ पोल एंड एंटर विथ साउथ पोल। हाँ बेटा, इसके ऊपर भी एक बार एग्जाम में क्वेश्चन आकर है। व्हाट दे हैव डन इज दे हैव गिवन टू डिफरेंट पीसेस, व्हाट दे हैव गिवन, two different magnetic fields they have given. For example, I'll show you, let me have a check, 1 minute. Okay, please observe here, the question could be like this. I think I need to use a board. Pen is available. Let me see. Huh. Let me take this itself. Or marker. See here. This is one magnet. Assume. This is one magnet. There are two magnets. Like this they have given. Here they have given as this is North Pole. This is South Pole. Are you getting? Again, even here also they have given North Pole and this is South Pole. Any doubt? Always remember, magnetic field lines emerge from North Pole. From where they will emerge?
North Pole.
Just I am writing like this. Okay. Emerge. What children?
Emerge.
Emerge means start. Merge. M-E. It's difficult. In keyboard only, I am writing. In paint. Okay. Merge. Merge means end. Always they start from North Pole and end at South Pole in this direction. This is important. This direction is important. Any doubts? Again, even here also, they will start from North Pole and end at South Pole. Is this clear? So, this is the direction. Correct? Then, this is option A. Okay. Option B. Understood? Option B. Let me say, this is North Pole. This is
South Pole.
This is South Pole. This is North Pole. Option B. This is the direction. Again, this is the direction. Again, this is the direction. Again, this is the direction. Option B is correct? Can you see this? They emerge from North Pole. Merge at South Pole. Arrow mark, can you see this? This is the arrow mark, right? Again, here also, they start from North Pole going towards South Pole. This is the direction. So, this is correct. Even this side, North Pole to South Pole, correct? North Pole to South Pole, correct? And apart from that, even this lines also matters. If they give you like this, is this correct?
Did you see what is given
over there? पूरा अब हमें क्या करते हैं ऊपर के लेंस को देख डालते हैं ये सेंटर के लेंस को भूल जाते हैं. So how it's moving? They are moving from south to north. Is it correct?
No.
How they should move? They should move in this direction. Then this is correct. Any doubts? So even you can get a question like this also based on this sentence. Can you see this? Based on this line, they may ask you the questions in the diagrammatical way. So, don't get confused. So, magnetic field lines, they leave from North Pole, means they start from the North Pole and end at South Pole. Outside, they seem to travel from North to South, but inside from South to North. Vice versa. Magnet ke bahar, North se South ko ja rahe hain. Lekin magnet ke andar, South se North ko ja rahe hain. Don't get confused. Outside north to south, but inside south to north. Any doubts? Yeah. So what is the direction of current in a straight current carrying conductor? Which is the current carrying conductor? This one. Just now we have seen, no? Yes. This is a straight current carrying conductor. Can you see this line? Can you see this rope? Can you see this pipe? This is a current carrying conductor. Understood? In a current carrying conductor, in a straight current carrying conductor. Now, what is the question? डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट इज नॉर्थ टू साउथ, कहां से जा रहा है बेटा? अगर से करंट नॉर्थ से साउथ को जा रहा है, मतलब कि ऊपर से नीचे आ रहा है, करंट इज फ्लोइंग इन विच डायरेक्शन? फ्रॉम नॉर्थ टू साउथ, ऊपर से नीचे आ रहा है, तो आपका राइट हैंड यूज करना है. प्लीज होल्ड योर राइट फिंगर, टेक योर राइट हैंड, क्लोज फोर फिंगर्स, टेक योर थंब एंड प्लीज स्ट्रेच लाइक दिस. यू हैव टू फील दिस, यू हैव टू एक्सपीरियंस दिस. आपको क्या करना है, डाउनवर्ड एरो मार्क में आपको थंब को रखना है. आपका एक सीधा हाथ लीजिए, अब थम्स अप नहीं करना है, थम डाउन करना है. कैन यू सी दिस, कैन यू सी दिस? नो. वेयर दिस फोर फिंगर इंडिकेट्स, इन विच डायरेक्शन फोर फिंगर्स आर? टुवर्ड्स ईस्ट, टुवर्ड्स ईस्ट, ईस्ट वेस्ट, नॉर्थ साउथ, ईस्ट और वेस्ट, इंडिया इज द बेस्ट. हाँ, गुड. एनी डाउट्स? इफ द करंट इज मूविंग फ्रॉम नॉर्थ टू साउथ, डिफ्लेक्शन of the magnetic field will be towards east. If current is moving from south to north, agar se niche se upar ja raha hai current, so how the deflection? Towards west. Can you see that above two diagrams? Can you see? From north to south east. Yes. Can you see this? Yeah. North. This is north. This is north. This is south. Can you see this? Towards fingers, north to south, towards east, south to north, towards west. Did you see? Beta, samajh mein aaya nahi? Haan. So that thing you have to remember. So that is the final conclusion about when the current carrying conductor is, when a straight current carrying conductor we are going to use. Samajh mein beta? When, how the magnetic field will be there in a straight current carrying conductor, means you have to write these two points. So how the magnetic field will be there in the straight carrying when straight current carrying conductor, when the direction of current is north to south, deflection of the magnetic field will be towards east. When the direction of current is south to north, then deflection of magnetic needle or the deflection of the magnetic field to will be towards west. Only you have to write these two points. Bas aapko ek cheez yaad rakhna hai. Kya yaad rakhna hai? A word. What is this word? Current carrying conductor. And here magnetic field. So magnetic field in a straight current carrying conductor. If you get this type of question, these two points you need to remember. Followed? Understood? Similarly, magnetic field due to current through a straight conductor, same thing. Can you see this? Now they have given this into this clockwise and anti-clockwise words. What jo east west hum padhe na abhi? Now only we have seen east and west, no? Which word ko aapko east direction mein diya hai. Can you see this? If the current flows in upward direction, upward means what? South to north, upward, niche se upar, south to north, then the deflection will be anti-clockwise direction. Agar se aapko east-west, agar se confusion raha, to aap India is best ko use kar sakte hai. What is India is best? Clockwise, anti-clockwise. Understood? If the deflection, if the current is flowing upward direction, Kashif, if the current is moving in the upward direction, what anti-clockwise? Magnetic field, deflection. Deflection will be in the anti-clockwise direction. If current is flowing in the downward direction, clockwise. Just you have to remember these two points. Samajh gaya beta? Agar se niche aa raha hai, to clock kaisa move hota hai? You have seen, right? Clock 12, 1, 2, 3, that is clockwise. Uska opposite mein agar se ghadiyal move hua to anti-clockwise. Any doubts? Till when we are alive, clockwise. After death, anti-clockwise. Understood? Good. Now, next question. Write the factors affecting the strength of magnetic field around a straight current carrying conductor. So, which are the factors affecting the magnetic field? Kaun se factors magnetic field ko affect kar rahe hain? So, please, you can go with these points. Okay. Magnetic field due to current in a solenoid. This is also one of the major important question. Don't forget it. What is electromagnet? Uses of electromagnet, they may ask you. What is how is the magnetic field in a circular loop? Electric motor. Can you see this? This is the electric motor. So this is the 3D dimension. This is the 3D. This is the 2D diagram. Usually we write this 2D. Actually inside how this will be? A part dikh raha hai beta? Can you see this part? A part aisa dikhta hai. Andar. Inside. Got it? Principle of electric motor, construction of electric motor, working of electric motor, and remember what is commutator. One of the most important question. What is commutator? Commutator, it reverses the direction of current in a coil. Current ko reverse karne ke liye hum commutator ko istemal karte hain. Understood? Jaise ki you have seen your AC dynamo and DC dynamo. In the previous class we have discussed. देखो बेटा अभी एसी में क्या हो रहा है और डीसी में क्या हो रहा है. कैन यू सी दिस? इन अल्टरनेट करंट द करंट फर्स्ट हाफ साइकिल इट मूव्स लाइक दिस, सेकंड हाफ साइकिल इट मूव्स लाइक दिस. करेक्ट? एक्चुअली दिस इज रॉन्ग. क्यों बोले तो इसमें कितना विड्थ और हाइट आना है इसमें भी उतना ही आना है. ओके, जस्ट आई एम शोइंग रफली. इन मोटर केस हाउ इट मूव्स, फर्स्ट हाफ साइकिल इट मूव्स इन दिस डायरेक्शन, सेकेंड हाफ साइकिल ऑल्सो it moves in the same direction. Understood? So who is helping to move in the same direction? Every half cycle it has to reverse the direction, right? But it is moving in the same direction. Who is helping? Commutator. Understood now? Understood? It reverses the direction of the current in a armature coil. So remember, working of electric motor, then commercial motor uses, they may ask you this. Write the uses of commercial motor. Okay, uses of DC motor. Understood? And electric generator, construction, working of electric generator. My dear students, still if you are not yet subscribed to our YouTube channel, Shasar Classes, kindly do subscribe it and click the bell icon. If you have liked this video, do not forget to click the like button. And also to share with your beloved ones. Good. Next question. Differences between AC generator and DC generator. Followed. Differences between electric motor and electric generator. Differences between AC current and DC current. Followed. Electromagnetic induction, what is galvanometer, Faraday's experiment, domestic electric circuit, electric fuse, overloading, short circuit. I hope one of our students had a doubt. Sir, write the difference between overloading and short circuit. What is the difference? As you can see here, here it's been given. The differences between overloading and short circuit. How exactly it happens? Okay, and this is about overloading. And what are the precautions should be taken to avoid overloading? What precautions has to be taken? Next chapter, light. What is refraction of light? They may ask you this question. Can you see here? Refractive index of water is 1.33. What do you mean by this? They will ask you this question. Refractive index of water is 1.33. What do you mean by this? Means you have to write that. This means that the ratio of speed of light in air and speed of light in water is equal to 1.33. That is the meaning. So what is the refractive index of glass is 1.52. What do you mean by this? Justify this statement. You should write this means that ratio of speed of light in air and speed of light in crown glass is equal to 1.52. Understood? So what do you mean by refractive index of diamond is 2.42? This means that ratio of speed of light in air and speed of light in diamond is equal to 2.42. Any doubts? Important question. Next, differences between convex lens and concave lens. And these are the important definitions. Optical center, center of curvature, principal aperture, principal axis, focal length. Next, image formation by convex lens. I hope you remember. कॉनकेव मिरर कॉन्वेक्स लेंस प्रॉपर्टीज आर सिमिलर ऑपोजिट कॉनकेव मिरर कॉन्वेक्स लेंस कॉन्वेक्स मिरर कॉनकेव लेंस रिमेंबर राइट गुड एंड रिमेंबर द रे डायग्राम्स साइन कन्वेंशन रिमेंबर लेंस फार्मूला मिरर फार्मूला मैग्निफिकेशन सो व्हाट इज द मिरर फार्मूला हाउ टू रिमेंबर मैग्निफिकेशन व्हाट इज मैग्निफिकेशन माइनस माइनस वी बाई यू सो मिरर फार्मूला वन बाई वी इज इक्वल वन बाई एफ इज इक्वल्स टू वन बाई वी प्लस वन बाई यू लेंस फार्मूला वन बाई एफ इज इक्वल्स टू वन बाई वी माइनस वन बाई यू एनी डाउट्स What is power of lens? Remember, electric power is different. Power of lens is different. So, what is power of lens? It is defined as reciprocal of its focal length. So, P is equals to 1 by F. Reciprocal of focal length is called as power. SI unit of power of lens is diopter. Understood? Understood? हाँ बेटा अगर से क्वेश्चन में आपको प्लस 2.0 देकर है तो याद रख लो उसको बोलते हैं कॉन्वेक्स अगर से आपको पावर माइनस में आया तो कौन सा लेंस यूज करना है कॉनकेव लेंस यूज करना है याद रख लीजिए इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट अंडरस्टूड इफ पावर ऑफ लेंस इज नेगेटिव देन विच लेंस हैज टू बी यूज कॉनकेव लेंस इफ पावर ऑफ लेंस इज प्लस कुछ भी हो सकता है 2.0 ही आना जरूरी नहीं है You will get 1.5 also, 3 also, 5 also. But major point is what? Positive. If power of lens is positive, then which lens we have to use? Convex. If power is negative? Concave. Samajh mein beta? Negative raha to concave, positive raha to convex. Recording. Next, sources of energy. What are the qualities of an ideal source of energy? I hope you remember. What are the qualities should have for the ideal source of energy? It should be cheap, available, easy to transport, easy to handle, high calorific value, proper ignition temperature. So these all qualities, if they have, then it is a good source of energy. Do you remember? What are the qualities or what are the properties should have for the good source of energy? Our ideal source of energy. So these properties. Advantages of producing hydroelectricity power. Agar se hum hydroelectricity use kar rahe hain, to uska advantage kya hai? I hope you remember. Yes. Next, advantages of renewable sources and non-renewable sources of energy. Got it? Renewable use karne se jaise ki dabe one more important question. Which is the best give an example of renewable source of energy? Which is the best example? We have multiple. So many renewable sources of energies are there. Usually you will get this question in multiple choice. Choose the correct answer. Best example? Solar energy. Remember. Which is the best example of renewable source of energy? Solar energy. We have wind energy also. That is also renewable. Wind energy, hydroelectricity, tidal energy, ocean thermal energy, geothermal energy. These all are renewable only. But the best one is solar energy. Similarly, which is the best example of non-renewable source of energy? Everyone knows fossil fuels. I agree. But one more. Electricity. Electricity is non-renewable source of energy. Don't forget. Any doubts? Electricity and fossil fuels. So, write the disadvantages of hydropower plant. Yesterday we have discussed, right? Disadvantages of hydropower plant like it will decrease the fertility of the soil do you remember and also it requires more area for construction maintenance cost will be high are you getting and also it requires an reservoir a big dam is required to store the water that is reservoir is required then only we can store huge amount of water that huge amount of water we can use to produce electricity by using hydroelectric power plant. So these are the disadvantages. Any doubts? Next, what are the limitations in obtaining energy from wind? Same. So it means they are asking disadvantages. Limitations are nothing but disadvantages to get an energy from the wind. So which are the disadvantages? Disadvantage kya hai beta? Maintenance cost is more, initial investment is more, and also it is been operated in the limited areas because it should have the speed of the wind, at least it should be 15 km per hour. The speed of the wind, and the speed of the wind is not same in all the areas. Only specific areas only the speed of the wind is more than 15 km per hour. Only in that specific areas only we can install the wind turbines. We cannot install the wind turbines everywhere, wherever we want, isn't it? And it should have, it should what we say that, so maintenance cost is more. So these things you have to write. And also output is less. उसका मतलब हमें इंस्टेंटली हमना ज्यादा विंड एनर्जी से इलेक्ट्रिसिटी प्रोड्यूस नहीं हो सकती है. वी कैन नॉट गेट मोर आउटपुट, वी कैन नॉट गेट मोर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, वी कैन नॉट जनरेट मोर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बाय यूजिंग विंड टर्बाइन एज यू कंपेयर टू योर न्यूक्लियर एनर्जी. न्यूक्लियर एनर्जी में कितना अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी हमारे को मिलता है, कितना स्पीड में हमारे को करेंट मिलता है, उतना विंड एनर्जी में नहीं मिलेगा. बिकॉज एज पर द चेंज ऑफ द विंड there will be a fluctuation in the production of electricity. Samajh mein beta? Now, reasons to which the biogas is considered to be an excellent fuel. One more important question. Which is the best example of excellent fuel? Biogas. Biogas is an best example of excellent fuel, efficient fuel, best fuel, biogas. Why? Because it is pollution free, isn't it? It is obtained in cheaper cost, and also it doesn't pollute the atmosphere, already we have written, and maintenance cost is less, it is feasible. Understood? So those points you are supposed to write. What are the environmental consequences of the increasing demand for energy? What steps would you suggest to reduce energy consumption? This is 3-mark question. Next. Here we have done with physics, and one more chapter is left out over here, that is human eye and a colorful world. Okay, in human eye and a colorful world, I hope you remember the table which you need to remember. Myopia, what is power of accommodation, defects of vision, reason and remedial measure. Myopia, hypermetropia, presbyopia, cataract. Remember, and next important question from human eye, briefly explain the formation of rainbow, it's a 3-mark question. One more important definition from the chapter, and very important, don't neglect it. What is dispersion of light? What is Tyndall effect? What is scattering of light? 1-mark definition. What is dispersion of light? What is Tyndall effect? And what is scattering of light? And in that chapter, we have 4 to 5 different give reason questions. Why the stars twinkle? Why the planet do not twinkle? Why sun appear red in the morning? Understood? For astronaut, the sky looks dark. Why? What is the reason? So there are some give reasons are there in your textbook. Same give reasons questions only you need to study. So there you can expect direct questions from the chapter. So please don't neglect it. And also dispersion of light in a prism. They may ask you this. This is also a 3-mark question. Briefly explain the dispersion of light in a glass prism. Understood? Vibgayor, formation, colors of light. So that phenomena, that recombinant technology you need to explain. In this major 3-mark long answer carrying questions is formation of rainbow, dispersion of light in a glass prism. These are the two big standard questions for 3 marks, and rest of the questions like defects of vision and give reasons questions from that chapter, nothing else. Any doubts? Is this clear? Now let me come back to the chapter chemistry. The topic chemistry. Here we have done with physics. I hope you might have understood the different ways how the questions can appear. Acid, bases and salts, indicator. What are indicators? 1 minute. What is indicator? My question is, what is indicator? Yes, it is a substance or it is an instrument which is used to detect whether the given substance is acid or base. To identify whether the given substance is acid or base, to check that, we use indicators. Indicators are used to check the given substance are acids or bases. So here we have different types of indicators: natural indicator, synthetic indicator, olfactory indicator. बेटा इसके अंदर तुम ना कौन भी उठा को क्वेश्चन ऐसा नहीं पूछते, जैसे कि व्हाट इज नेचुरल इंडिकेटर, दे वोंट गिव. हाउ दे विल आस्क, दे विल गिव एग्जांपल एंड दे विल आस्क यू आइडेंटिफाई विच इंडिकेटर इज दिस. दिस इज एन एग्जांपल ऑफ डैश इंडिकेटर, फॉलोड. दिस इज एन एग्जांपल ऑफ, दिस मीन्स वॉट एग्जाम्पल, लिटमस. लिटमस पेपर इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ डैश इंडिकेटर, दैट्स इट. लिटमस इज विच इंडिकेटर, natural indicator. Similarly, turmeric, red cabbage, some flowers and color petals, these all are natural indicator. Red is danger. Danger means acid. What is red? Danger. Danger means acid. Opposite is blue. So blue is base. First letter is B. B-L-U-E, blue. First letter of base is B. So matching, simple. Any doubts? Danger is red, so red is acid. Blue first letter is blue. Base first letter is B. BB, blue base. Okay. So types of media. Acidic media means litmus will change into red color. Base media, if the given substance is base, basic medium, then litmus paper will change into blue color. So this is natural indicator. Any doubts? Understood or not? Good. Similarly, example, take one knife, cut your finger. What happens? Imagine. Blood will come. Yes or no? To avoid the blood, to avoid the flow of blood, what we do? We use turmeric powder. हल्दी लेको, अगर से खून जिधर पे आ रहा है उधर लगा दो, खून खड़ जाएगा. सो दिस रिएक्शन इज न्यूट्रलाइजेशन रिएक्शन. डिड यू अंडरस्टूड? वंस इफ यू कट, ब्लड फ्लो विल बी देयर, इट मीन्स दैट इज एसिड. टू स्टॉप दैट वी अप्लाई बेस. सो व्हाट हैपेंस, रिएक्शन बिकम न्यूट्रल, मीन्स पहले जैसा थे अब वैसे ही है. एनी डाउट्स? अंडरस्टूड? अगर से आपको खून आ रहा है तो फौरन हल्दी लीजिए, टर्मरिक पाउडर लीजिए, खून जिधर पे आ रहा है उधर लगा दीजिए तो खून खड़ जाएगा. इट एक्ट्स एज ए बैंडेज, नेचुरल बैंडेज. इसी तरह से कॉफ़ी पाउडर वो भी लगा दीजिए, द फ्लो ऑफ ब्लड विल स्टॉप क्विकली. अगर से बैंडेज कहीं पे नहीं है तो कॉफ़ी पाउडर या टर्मरिक पाउडर लगा दीजिए, क्या हो जाएगा बेटा? सो रिएक्शन न्यूट्रल हो जाएगा. रिएक्शन क्या हो जाएगा? न्यूट्रल. अगर से खून आ रहा है उधर, इंस्टेड ऑफ टर्मरिक पाउडर, चिल्ली पाउडर इफ यू अप्लाई, देन रिएक्शन विल बिकम डबल. सो न्यूक्लियर ब्लास्ट. ओके, एनी डाउट्स? गुड. नेक्स्ट इज सिंथेटिक इंडिकेटर. बेटा दिस क्वेश्चन इज इंपॉर्टेंट, डोंट फॉरगेट. एग्जाम्पल, understood, it's a artificial substance. This is obtained as artificial. Artificial means we have prepared. Hame bana kare. Hame ka matlab? Hame. Good. V. Phenolphthalein. What is the indicator name? Phenolphthalein. This is the name of the indicator. And methyl orange. Methyl orange. Any doubts? Yeah, now you can see. Agar se wo acidic media hai. फेनोथलिन एग्जाम्पल, आपका एक सब्सटेंस है, सिमजिए, यू हैव वन सब्सटेंस. ओके, अब वो सब्सटेंस वो एसिडिक है या बेसिक है, हमारे को चेक करना है. हाउ विल यू डिटरमाइन, हाउ विल यू चेक? अगर से आप ये इंडिकेटर को यूज़ किए, फेनोथलिन इंडिकेटर को यूज़ किए, तो अगर से वो एसिडिक रहा तो कलरलेस हो जाएगा, अगर से बेसिक मीडिया रहा तो पिंक कलर में चेंज हो जाएगा, अगर से न्यूट्रल मीडिया रहा तो कलरलेस. मिथाइल ऑरेंज, इफ इट इज एसिडिक मीडिया, इट चेंज इनटू रेड कलर. If it is basic media, it change into yellow color. If it is neutral, then it change into orange color. So color changes. By using the change of the color, we can predict that the given substance is acidic or basic. That's it. समझ में आ बेटा? वो मीडिया यूज कर रहे हैं, समझ में आया? जैसे कि एग्जाम्पल, अज्यूम इट्स लाइक ए इंक, इंक के जैसा. अब हमें फेनोल्थेलिन इंडिकेटर को लिए बेटा, एक ग्लास में था, एक बॉटल में लिक्विड के जैसा था, समझिए. वो ड्रॉप्स आते हैं ना, वो ड्रॉप्स के जैसा लेकर वो उसके ऊपर डालिए, डालने के बाद उसके अंदर कलर चेंज होगा. उसको देखकर उस जो भी कलर आ रहा है, फॉर्मेशन हो रहा है, उस कलर को देख के आप बोल सकते हैं कि वो एसिड है या बेस है. दैट्स इट आफ्टर कलर चेंज. एनी डाउट्स? ऑल फैक्ट्री इंडिकेटर, इट्स ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, डोंट फॉरगेट. व्हाट इज ऑल फैक्ट्री इंडिकेटर? दिस आर द इंडिकेटर्स विच वी यूज. दिस इंडिकेटर्स आर नथिंग बट बाई यूजिंग ए स्मेल ऑर्डर. स्मेल को देख के हम बता सकते हैं कि वो एसिड है या बेस है. But it is not recommended for everything because even it you have to use the precautions in case if you have to use this olfactory indicators. Onion, vanilla and clove extract olfactory indicators. जैसे कि काली मिर्ची है, सुन के भी आप बोल सकते हैं ओ ये काली मिर्ची है. Are you getting my point? Chili powder है, सुन के भी आप बोल सकते हैं हाँ this is chili powder. Onion है, जस्ट उसके स्मेल से आप प्रेडिक्ट कर सकते हैं कि वो ऑनियन है. आर यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? सो दिस इज हाउ विच परफॉर्म्स. हाउ डू एसिड्स एंड बेसिस रिएक्ट विथ मेटल्स? रिमेंबर इन दिस मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन इज दिस. व्हाट इज दिस? दिस दे विल आस्क यू विच इज द गैस इज लिबरेटेड व्हेन एसिड रिएक्ट्स विथ मेटल और बेसिस रिएक्ट विथ मेटल. चाहे एसिड या बेस दो में से कोई भी अगर से रिएक्ट हो रहे हैं तो आपको कौन सा गैस लिबरेट होगा? हाइड्रोजन गैस. एंड ऑल्सो दे विल आस्क यू दिस इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. कैन यू सी दिस? कैन यू सी दिस? हाँ दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. व्हाई दिस क्वेश्चन इज इंपॉर्टेंट? बिकॉज सी हियर, कैन यू सी दिस हाइड्रोजन गैस कन्फर्मेशन. ओनली हाइड्रोजन गैस बर्न्स मेकिंग ए पॉप साउंड. कैन यू सी दिस? If burning candle near a gas filled bubble, you have the diagram?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? Hydrogen gas test, pop test. Can you remember?
Yes, sir.
Haan. Here, when base reacts with metal, जब भी एक बेस मेटल के साथ रिएक्ट होगा तो उसमें भी क्या हो रहा है? साल्ट और गैस आ रहा है. साल्ट एंड हाइड्रोजन गैस इज लिबरेटेड. बट इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल विथ ऑल मेटल्स. दैट इज द इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टी. Understood or not? Understood or not? It means, can you see here? Sodium hydroxide is base. Can you see here? NaOH. Sodium hydroxide is base. When it react with zinc, it gives sodium zincate. And hydrogen gas is liberated. This is important property. Please remember this formula and also this reaction. Don't forget. Understood? What happens when sodium hydroxide reacts with zinc? When sodium hydroxide reacts with zinc, sodium zincate is formed. Don't forget this point. Next, how do metal carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonates react with acids? So this question carries 3 marks. You are supposed to write till here. This complete page you are supposed to write. Beta, iske upar tumna 1 mark ke bhi questions aa sakte hain. Please do remember. And also this question, if they ask you 3 marks. 1 mark, 2 mark, 3 mark. All the possibility questions are there in this paragraph. Don't forget it. How do acids and bases react with each other? That is nothing but they may ask you straightforward question. What is neutralization reaction? Give an example. Important question. Reaction of metal oxide with acids. Reaction of non-metallic oxide with base. What do all acids and bases have in common? What are alkalis? द बेसिस विच आर सॉल्यूबल इन वाटर. जो भी बेसिस पानी में डिजोल्व हो सकते हैं, रिएक्ट हो सकते हैं, उनको हम बोलते हैं चंपाकलीस, सॉरी आलकलीस. ओके एंड रिमेंबर दे आर सोपी इन टच. उसके अर्थ चंपाकली बोले बेटा. देखो छिए तो सॉफ्ट रहती, सोपी इन टच. खाई कर को बोले तो बिटर एंड करोसिव. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अनारकलीस, सॉरी आलकलीस. एनी डाउट्स? दिखने में सॉफ्ट टच, खाए बोले तो बिटर एंड करोसिव. सो दे आर कॉल्ड एज अल्कलीज. एनी डाउट्स? Understood?
Yes, sir.
Now, what is neutralization reaction? Give example. What happens when acid added to water? Which is recommended, they may ask you. Whether you want to add acid with water or water and water with acid. Understood? What is strong acid? What are weak acids? What are concentrated acids? And what are dilute acids? Children, here is important question. Write the differences between concentrated acids and dilute acids. I will give one small example to make sure the difference between concentrated and dilute. Take 1 liter of milk. What? 1 liter of milk and 1/2 liter of water mix. That is A. Again, other side take 1 liter of milk, 5 liters of water mix. Can you see any change?
Yes, sir.
1 liter pani, 1/2 liter, 1 liter doodh, 1/2 liter pani. Other side, 1 liter doodh, 5 liter pani. Ab isme gaadha kon hai, patla kon hai? Pani kisme zyada hai? B mein. 5 liter pani. Kon mar raha? Unhe solute. Kon marne ja raha? Unhe solvent. Understood? Kon marra? The one who is dying, solute. Who is killing him? Solvent. Yes. Remember, who is dying? He is solute. Marne wala? Solute. Marra so kon? Who is killing him? He is solvent. Example. You don't know swimming. Assume. You don't know swimming. Die into the water. Water में एक छलांग लगाओ तो क्या होती? Assume. What happens? You will die because you don't know swimming, isn't it? अब इसमें solute कौन, solvent कौन? Solute is you. Solvent is water. If we have less solvent, कम पानी है तो हम उसको बोलते हैं कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड. अगर से ज्यादा सॉल्वेंट है, ज्यादा पानी है, देन वी कॉल्ड एज डाइल्यूट. गाढ़ा कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड, पतला डाइल्यूट. एनी डाउट्स? अंडरस्टूड? इफ यू हैव मिनिमम अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर, कैन यू सी दिस? एसिड और बेस विच कंटेन्स मिनिमम पॉसिबल अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर, then it is known as concentrated acid. The acid base contains more amount of water, then it is called as dilute. Got the difference between concentrated and dilute? समझ में आ बेटा? मारने वाले से मरने वाला बड़ा है. किसमें? Dilute में. मारने वाले से बचाने वाला बड़ा है. Concentrated. Any doubts? 1 mark question. What is dilution? What is dilution? pH scale, remember, and also remember this saliva. Here they may ask you, tomato juice, acidic gastric juice. Okay, you can just make out. And neutral is 7. Tap water, pure water is 7. That is neutral. Importance of pH in everyday life. What is the pH of the soil in your backyard? Important question. pH in your digestive system. pH changes is the cause of tooth decay and how to prevent it. Self-defense, can you see here? It's been illustrated and it's given clearly. So it's easy to understand also. Natural source. Beta, ye question tumna subah ke exam mein aa sakta. 1 mark. नेचुरल सोर्स विनेगर, ऑरेंज, टैमरिंड, टोमेटो. विनेगर में कौन सा एसिड है? प्लीज बी केयरफुल विद दिस क्वेश्चन. अगेन आई एम रिपीटिंग, टुमारो 100% ऑन दिस टेबल यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट 1 क्वेश्चन. 100% विनेगर एसिडिक एसिड, ऑरेंज सिट्रिक एसिड, टैमरिंड टार्टरिक एसिड, टोमेटो ऑक्सैलिक एसिड, सोर मिल्क लैक्टिक एसिड, लेमन citric acid, ant string methanoic acid, nettle string methanoic acid. Remember methanoic acid. Any doubts? metals and non-metals, and you remember, so these are the properties of metals. Can you see this? Metals are having a metallic luster. Luster means shining. They are hard. They have the property of malleability, ductility. They are good conductor of heat and electricity, and they are sonorous. Sonorous means they produce sound. Examples are given here. Can you see this? And also they have given. Can you see this malleability example, ductility example, and also sonorous example. They are used to make belts because they have the property of sonorous. Beta, iske upar tumna indirect question aa sakta. Metals have the metals are used to make the belts. Metals are used to make or to manufacture belts. Understood? Name the property of the metal which illustrate this example. Metals are sonorous. Yes, you have to write that property name. Understood? Tomorrow is the exam. Next. Now, you can see here physical properties. Differences between metals and non-metals. Exception in physical properties. Exception ka matlab kya beta? They are metal, but they behave like non-metal. They are non-metal, but they behave like metal. Understood? Example, iodine, mercury, gallium and cesium, lithium, sodium, potassium, diamond, graphite. Exception property, it is lustrous non-metal. Can you see this? Iodine, it is a lustrous non-metal. Samajh mein beta? It's a lustrous mercury. It's a liquid metal. Gallium and cesium, they have low melting and boiling point. Lithium, sodium, potassium, they are soft metal and have low density metal. Diamond, hardest natural substance. Graphite, it's a non-metal. Unhe kya beta? Non-metal. Lekin property kya? They conduct electricity. Understood? Usually non-metals will not conduct electricity, but this one is conducting electricity. Being a non-metal, behaves like metal. Any doubts? Chemical properties of metals? Important question. Beta, what is neutralization reaction? Agar se nahi aaya, to what are amphoteric oxides aata? Agar se water amphoteric oxides question nahi aaya, then what is alloy aata? Understood? What are amphoteric substances? Reaction of metals with water. Reaction with dilute acid. What is aqua regia? One more question. What is aqua regia? Freshly prepared mixture of concentrated hydrochloric acid and concentrated nitric acid in the ratio of 3:1 is called as aqua regia. Don't forget. Any doubts? Reaction of metals with other metals. This question could be your. This question could be your. Could be your reactivity series based question. Remember, metal X react with. Can you see this Fe? Remember, iron react with some metal is there which displaces copper. Like such type of questions you will get. So this paragraph is important. So this on this based on this paragraph you can expect a 3-mark question. Don't forget it. Any doubts? How do metals and non-metals react? Very important question. What? Write the properties of ionic compounds. Beta, properties of? 1 minute. Properties of magnetic field lines. Important. Similarly, properties of ionic compounds are also important. Don't get confused. Next, occurrence of metals. Can you see this? How we get mineral? How ore is occurred? How gangue is occurred? What is gangue? One more question. What is mineral? What is ore? Write the difference between mineral and ore. Mineral, the elements or compounds which occur naturally in the earth crust is known as mineral. Mineral that contains high percentage of metal that can be extracted profitably from it, that is ore. Ores mined from the earth contain large amount of impurities such as sand, soil, etc. are called as gangue. Extraction of metals, low in reactivity series. Extraction of metals in the middle of the activity series. What is thermite reaction? Very important question. Seriously, this question has already appeared in the exam. What is thermite reaction? Reaction of iron oxide with aluminium used to join railway tracks or cracked machine parts is known as thermite reaction. Extraction of metals, high in the activity series. What is electrolytic refining? At anode, what is obtained? At cathode, what is obtained? They may ask you this question. बेटा ये डायग्राम देखो, ये डायग्राम के ऊपर ये क्वेश्चन पूछ सकता. नेम द पार्ट्स, नेम द पार्ट विच इज कलेक्टेड एट एनोड एंड कैथोड. व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रोलाइट, व्हाट इज करोशन, प्रिवेंटिव मेजर्स. हाँ, दिस इज माय फेवरेट क्वेश्चन. व्हाट इज अलॉय. हाँ, दिस इज माय अनदर फेवरेट क्वेश्चन. बेस्ड ऑन दिस टेबल गारंटीड यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट ए क्वेश्चन. स्टील, कैन सी दिस अलॉय नेम इज स्टील. कॉम्पोजिशन, इसमें क्या क्या है? आयरन और कार्बन है. प्रॉपर्टी, हार्ड एंड स्ट्रॉन्ग. यूजर्स, कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ बिल्डिंग, ब्रिजेस एंड रेलवे ट्रैक. स्टेनलेस स्टील. कॉम्पोजिशन, एक कौन से, ये स्टेनलेस स्टील इज द नेम ऑफ द अलॉय. ये बनाने के लिए किस किस का इस्तेमाल किया है? आयरन, निकल एंड कोबाल्ट. उसके प्रॉपर्टी क्या है? शाइनी, हार्ड, स्ट्रॉन्ग, डज नॉट रस्ट. वेयर वी यूज, यूटेंसिल, सर्जिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स. सिमिलरली ब्रास, ब्रॉन्ज, सोल्डर, अमलगम, अलॉय ऑफ गोल्ड. अमलगम, रिमेंबर. Any doubts? Next, carbon and its compounds. Electron dot structures. Electron dot structures. What is allotropy? What is catenation? What is tetravalent nature? What are saturated hydrocarbons? Unsaturated hydrocarbons. What is isomerism? What is structural isomerism? What is homologous series? Very, very, very important question. Homologous series. Characteristics of homologous series. What is functional group? Based on this topic, compulsory you will get one question. Seriously, I'm telling. Based on the chemical properties of carbon compounds. They may ask you, what is combustion? Give an example. And also some important data is bit given here. Can you see this? In this combustion, saturated hydrocarbon forms a sooty flame. Unsaturated hydrocarbons burn with yellow smoky flame. Remember this. ये टॉपिक के ऊपर तुमने एग्जाम में क्या पॉइंट्स के ऊपर क्वेश्चंस आ सकती है, इट्स बीन गिवन हियर. सिमिलरली ऑक्सीडेशन रिएक्शन, विच इज द ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट. एडिशन रिएक्शन, सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शन. एंड राइट द डिफरेंस बिटवीन सोप एंड डिटर्जेंट. वेरी 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 माई फेवरेट इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. Briefly explain the cleansing action of soap. It's a 3-mark question. You are supposed to write same points as it is, nothing else. Classification of elements, that is periodic classification of elements. State Dobrynin-Loft reacts. Limitation, they won't ask advantages, usually they will ask limitations only. Similarly, what is Newland's law of octaves? Limitations. What is Mendeleev periodic law? In Mendeleev, they will ask you advantages and disadvantages, both. And state modern periodic law, even in this also they will ask you advantages and disadvantages, both. And here you can expect a question like this. Mendeleev periodic law ke ko se properties ko modern periodic law mein replace kiye gaye. Iska matlab Mendeleev ke kuch disadvantages the. So modern periodic law jab aaya, to uske disadvantages ko ne correct kare. Wo kon se points, they will ask you. Got it? Trends in modern periodic table, valency along with period donor group. Atomic size along with period donor group, what happens? Metallic character along with period donor group, non-metallic character. Biology passing package. How are the functions of arteries, veins and capillaries are interrelated in the circulation of blood? Do you remember differences between arteries, veins, veins and capillaries? Do you remember? Yes, this is the point. How does transportation of water takes place over the heights in a plant? The body temperature of frogs and lizards depend on temperature in the environment. Justify. Are you getting, children? Explain the process of translocation of food materials in plants. What are the methods used by plant to get rid of excretory products? Differences between xylem and phloem. Got it? Double circulation of blood, mammals and birds. Why it is necessary to separate deoxygenated blood? Give reasons. What is lymph function? Blood and lymph difference. Pulmonary artery, pulmonary vein difference. control and coordination. What happens at the synapse between two neurons? What are plant hormones? Why is the use of iodized salt advisable? How does our body respond when adrenaline is secreted into the blood? Why are some patients of diabetes treated by giving injections of insulin? Parts of neuron and their functions. Are you getting, children? Functions of auxin. Imagine the situation, clapping at the end of program, fluctuating blood pressure in the body. How these situations are functionally different give reason. We withdraw our leg when stepped on thorn unknowingly. काटे के ऊपर सडन पोर रख दिए तो पोम पीछे ले लेंगे. शाम को देखते ही भाग जाएंगे. ऐसे क्वेश्चंस इलस्ट्रेशंस दे विल गिव यू. As soon you found a snake, you will run away. Are you getting? Yes. Based on that question. And next, mention the important parts and their functions of human brain. Function of cerebrum, hypothalamus, cerebellum, medulla. What is reflex action, reflex arc? Difference between exocrine glands and endocrine glands. Children, this table is important. Don't forget this table. Different plant hormones and their functions. Very, very, very important question. Don't forget this. Our environment, biodegradable, non-biodegradable, substances difference. Excuse me. What is the role of decomposers in the ecosystem? What is ozone? How does it affect our atmosphere or ecosystem? How can you help in reducing the problem of waste disposal? Important function and presence of ozone in Earth atmosphere. How do organisms reproduce? How is the process of pollination is different from fertilization? Role of the seminal vesicles and prostate gland. Changes seen in girls at the time of puberty, very important. And this is very, very, very important. How does the embryo get nourished inside the mother's body? This question also can be asked like this. Write the function of placenta. This question is, write the functions of placenta. Both are one and the same. Got it? Why does menstruation occur? Very, very, very important question. Different methods of contraception, important. Different methods are there. And how you can control them. And what are the reasons? Explain the development of fertilized egg into a fetus in a woman. In women, how the surgical contraception methods can be used to prevent pregnancy. Explain the significant function of male reproductive and female reproductive. Expand STD. What is female foeticide? Write a note on female foeticide. Heredity and evolution. How is the sex of the child determined? Very important question. Explain the term analogous and homologous organs. Usually this question can be asked in differences. Write the difference between analogous and homologous organs. Why the factors lead to the rise in new species? This question is most repeated question. Importance of fossils. What is speciation? Acquired traits and inherited traits, differences. And explain the methods to estimate the age of fossils. What is monohybrid cross? Briefly explain them. Dihybrid cross, briefly explain them. And draw a neat diagram of Punnett square. Write the neat diagram of checkerboard. What is monohybrid ratio and dihybrid ratio? Sustainable management of natural resources. Advantages of reduce and reuse. Effects of deforestation. What is water table? Why is it important? Benefits of water harvesting. Stakeholders of forest. Are you getting? And what are the problems faced by construction of large dam? Important question. They will ask you advantages and disadvantages both by constructing the dams. Are you getting, children? Results of Chipko movement. Important question. Find out the traditional system, water harvesting or management in the region. The traditional system of water conservation different from the region. Explain. This is your 4-mark question. 2 or 3 mark question. And I hope you all have understood. So these all are the questions which is been asked in the exam and straightforward questions from your entire science question paper. And one more chapter is left out here, chemical reaction and equation. So balancing the chemical reaction important, and types of chemical reactions. And along with that, you need to remember what is oxidation and reduction reaction. And they may ask you which is oxidizing agent and reducing agent, and what is rancidity, and difference between rusting and corrosion. Is this clear? My dear students, I hope this video was helpful for you all. The content, it looks like a refreshment for you people of the entire year journey. So right from the start of your academic year till the end of the academic year, today you have seen the slideshow of the entire science of class 10th syllabus. Wish you all the best of luck. Do well. Keep watching to our YouTube channel, Shasar Classes. And if you are not subscribed, do subscribe, share, like, and comment. Take care. All the best.